Yes, Smart Wargames hier. Let's play Attack Sub, the board game or card game. It is from Avalon Hill. And yeah, I like modern submarines. As you might know by my channel, I like to play games that cover this aspect, this genre. And there's not much around, be it video games, be it board games. I was looking really for board games that cover modern submarining or modern ASW, anti-submarine warfare, but not much to be found. Yeah, there are some games that to some extent go into this area, like DVG, what's it called? Global Modern Naval Battles, Global Warfare, something like that. Also card-based, but entirely a different breed. Spruance Leader is coming up. That might involve submarining. Really excited for that. And yeah, I once saw on your YouTube, I think, a prototype of a submarine leader game for DVG, but the video is already some years old. I'm not sure if this will ever be a thing. I think that is really a uncovered area. Be it video games, be it sure we have something like Cold Waters and whatever. Successor of true submarine sims, true submarine games like Dangerous Waters would be great. Some good board games, I think. Some nice ideas that could translate well. So yeah, this game here, it is card-based. I played it a bit in order to try to figure out the rules because there is one unboxing video I found on YouTube, but other than that, I found absolutely no gameplay. Nowhere. So I had to dig into the rules, found some documents. There is also a tabletop simulator version of it, which comes with upgraded graphics. This game is, I don't know from when. 80s, 90s, perhaps. And sometimes those designs were more simpler then. So the unit cards look still great, but if you want newer, more shiny graphics, there were some community mods with upgraded graphics which got incorporated in the tabletop simulator version. However, out of convenience, I will play this one because this offers some script stuff. And I will play it. It is not really designed for solitaire play, so we will make an exception here. However, I found some forum that where people report you can play this rather good solitaire. There was some document, I couldn't find it. I need to dig if perhaps somebody can find it. I know some of you are really good in researching this stuff. Solitaire rules for Attack Sub. But it was basically about something not uncovering cards until you need to react. So yeah, this for me also a learning experience. If you watch this and want immediately to see perfect rules, won't happen. I'm not even sure if I can operate this game to its end. Yeah, so keep that in mind. Okay, however, what I know is both players, we will start as the US side. We have LA class, the first LA class, the Los Angeles, and the Baltimore. So 2688 facing off against two Victor Threes, Ivan Rogov and Wotsov. Wotsov. Yeah, I will play and explain while that, but right now it is not really meant as a tutorial. I think also sometimes you simply learn by watching somebody play. That is my approach also in many of my videos. Good. What I know is everybody starts with a base hand size of 3. You play basically cards and counter cards, like in other games, like in Down in Flames or whatever. Additionally, two further card, one card per active ship, boat, or helo are played. So every player has currently two active submarines, so two additional cards. Guy can carry up to 3 active helos. Oliver Hazard Perry and the Virginia, that is. He can gain contacts. 6 ASW torpedo tubes. But the Perry has better sensor value. November class. Yeah, let's detect the November class first and blow it out of the water. I mean, you can stack this fleet battles as big as you want. You could even do 10 ships with the system. This, of course, then taking quite long. Yeah, I'm back in a couple of minutes. Need to get something to drink. It is quite different from other card games, and Avalon Hill, usually no matter in what format they publish the games, they tried always to maintain a sense of realism. And it is a very slow game that is, I guess, for depicting submarine warfare pretty good, but once you went down a path, you could argue that you have little options with that. Little hand size and those cards not offering too many options. But I think that is true, yeah, for a modern submarine. Once you go down a path, there's no going back. Yeah, if you are detected, if an enemy has a strong lock on you, you can't pull off some Ramius maneuvers that is Hollywood. They will fire and probably connect with you sooner or later. So it is rather a game of planning. Who you want to get and prepare a good torpedo attack. Watch out with those active sonars, otherwise it might come back at you. Okay, now we will play the surface group here. Let's roll cards. Oh, I don't. And you're discarding a lot. Game. Sometimes that discard is better than do something. But yeah, contact reduction is always a good thing. But currently we have no contact levels, so nothing to use. We can attempt a passive detection. Yeah. The Hazard Perry has sensor value 3. Will attempt a passive detection while the yeah, we will discard one of those. I mean, damage control is also rather unlikely. It's discarded. That is the action of the Virginia. Passive of detection is. Yeah, against. Yeah, do we want to focus on the weaker boat? I guess better focus on the strong boat or Victor 3. And. Let's pick cards. 4 plus 3 is 5, 6, 7, which is exactly the value we need. So we got the Victor on the passives. But we need to play the Soviet cards, as they might outplay it. Which they do, yeah, they have a PS card, passive sonar card, they can play as reaction in order to prevent the, let's say, the Victor 3 went silent and the Simpson was not able to get the contact. Good, Soviet turn. Yeah, you could say the Virginia is somewhat exposed. Defense value 5, both have 8. Sensor value. They can take more damage. We could also send in the November class. See what happens. Yeah, there's a system shutdown, Sean. When you are hit, you can shut down your entire system and play that. I guess that was, I could imagine it was indeed considered like that. That when you are hit by or damaged, receive damage, flooding or whatever, that you of course need to consider that the battle space is floating. Enemy won't pause like in those movies. They might, if they get any sign of that you are still active, they might shoot on you. Could be that they were, this might be real consideration if you receive damage, which you first need to control, that you might bring down systems in order to spoof the enemy to believe that it was a kill blow. Yeah, we could close range. But I don't know if I want to close. But on the other hand, if this guy starts to deploy helos, those helos are now spinning up. Question is who wants to go in. Yeah, send the Victor 3 in. So we're playing close open range, COL. Can't be countered by the US. Could also argue if they even want that. And I want to get rid of the Perry, because a Perry can launch helos, up to 3 helos. Every helo will receive a card, and this might make it way more difficult. Oh, wait. Giga, no, it doesn't can carry 2 helos. Somewhere listed. Number of helos, 1. Yeah. I have 1 active helo. 3 helos, that is a number which you need to roll every turn if the helo stays active. You need to read about that. So they're not countering. Hey, where are those things? Green I need. Black contact level. And what is about? Ah, exactly right. Surface groups act as one. Exactly. If you have, how was it? Yeah. Surface groups contact levels act as one. If you have a fix on one, you have fix on both. That's why it is black. However, against submarines. No, both ships, is that true? Both ships now will get us a fix on me. Surface groups is a bit different. Yeah, all ships share the information between Link and will now receive information that the Victor 3 is closing in. Yeah, currently I don't plan to fire, so we will discard them. Okay, yeah, we draw a Hilo card. A Hilo is launched by the Simpson. And the Virginia can't do anything. Yeah, we need to check this number. The Hilo stays only airborne if you draw a random number card each turn higher than three. Or equal higher. The Hilo is considered as a separate asset, has own sensor and attack values. Okay, yeah, and the Hilo check is only performed if we attack, do a sensor check, or if we draw a he card with the keyword Hilo. But now it can stay and act as a further force, but will become active next turn. Yeah, we'll try a passive detection with the and the November class, because it has very bad sensor value, might go active sonar. Nothing is countered by the US, so let's check if we can get through the parries, or if we can pick up the parry. 6 plus 3, 9. Yes. Gain one contact on the surface group. Yeah, active sonar means basically we get one automatic. The entire surface group. Can now draw six cards. I guess some Hilo printed on. Does those cards even? just also a helicopter. Okay. That is basically a second helo card, Mike, to trigger a helo check. The helo has better attack values, but currently we are not going for an attack. We'll try to passive or active sonar detection on the missions. Do we want to go active? I don't think so. Go passive on the Victor 3. Two, five. Yeah, that is not enough. The Virginia will try to reduce the contact. On the Victor 3. That is... That worked out. Hilo will do currently enough. The helo, I mean, can the helo discard cards? Every ship was mentioned, so I guess not. A bit more aggressive with the Victor 3. You know what? How we will do it. The November will push in, and the Victor will try to remove its value. The November is pushing in. No COR card. Yeah, we can't play close range, open range. We might lose the helo with that. Is that a helo check or is the helo really lost then? Basically means that we reposition. can't find the information. Yeah, if you play a helo check is performed when we play close range. I won't do that right now. Play two contact reduction cards. Or fail. Victor is closing range, November is active sonar pinging. We could counter that. Will do. I don't want to have the sub closer to me. Active sonar can't be countered. The November class will go for the kill shot. The November class. Those November classes are that crazy stuff. Yeah, the lock on. And it has attack plus 2 against surface. Very. Watch for that November. Yeah, we need to play a contact reduction on Arvid. Maybe we have only one. No. At close range, but I don't want to do that. We play two contact reductions on each, which is not countered. Both fail. Yeah, November. But wait, is there any? Yeah, it has a good attack value. Yeah, 4 is not enough. 4 plus 2 plus random card, that is 6. We need to overcome 8 defense. Yeah, November. Where's the 5th card? Yeah, we might want to get the November close. They currently have 3 bad detection on the November. They will get 2. And then can fire back. November has nice defense. I'd rather double. They have all 8 teams. The Virginia has better attack. Because the Virginia can launch sub rocks, is that correct? S rocks, I mean. Yeah. That is S rock, ASW is a sub rock. The Parry can't do that. The Parry's primary weapon is the Hilo, primary ASW weapon. And the Virginia is using S rocks, so you could say that that is we can exert more authority against subs. Yeah, who wants to close range? Do we want to send in a November? Or do we want to wait and get the Victor 3 also closer? Victor 3 is better shielded against protection by passive. Better to have both submarines close and ready for attack. But we are currently parking here two torpedoes. Yeah, I mean those two torpedoes, we don't need to get closer. There's nothing we get from that. I think we will now prepare an attack. We will discard three cards. I can only discard two. And prepare the attack with a November class. And the helo can also be a burden. Because you can't close or disengage. If you feel that a submarine is perhaps preparing an attack, you could get out of the surface group could now do could get out of contact level in order to spoof the November class, which is now preparing for an attack, and then the tactic was useless. If you see that your enemy is starting to hold hands, you can already guess that something is coming for you. This game is quite interesting. I think if you play it very on high level, those rounds could take very long, I could imagine. Sure, it's a matter of taste, but on the other hand, it's also quite like chess. Very little random, I think. But I don't know, I mean, somebody that played this game over the years might have a different opinion. But that is my first impression. What is perhaps missing is a bit that the helo is not able somehow to act as a contact level platform. Can close in on its own or something. So yeah, I mean, it would complicate the game, but that is basically the deal. The big advantage of a helo is a helo can get close to a submarine, yeah, like that. And then the submarine has a huge problem. That's why they developed those anti-air submerged anti-air assets. They're also not really good because they can be detected. The helo has a big advantage. Yeah, a ship, if it tries to get close, it might get torpedoed. But a helo can come to you and check you out. So, by the helo carrier basically is the most effective ASW. Yeah, let's say naval asset. Yeah, of course, also P3 Orions and other SW fixed wing aircraft, but probably from crew aircraft carriers or land based. But they are also the same, yeah. But helos have the big advantage that they can roam a single spot pretty good. That is somehow not really reflected in this game. The helo is somehow tied to you and can't do anything on its own. The helo should be here the most scary opponent on this battlefield right now. Can a helo play, or does it really require a sensor detection, because those cards seem to be quite seldom. I don't see the necessity to use the helo for sensor detection, while the mothership can do that. If it could always do that, perhaps it is inheriting those actions, but I didn't read anything about that. That would be perhaps a different thing. If it comes basically with a sensor detection, active passive on board would be a good kicker. Okay, let's see what we want to do here. Yeah, the parry. Also here that the sensor value of the parry is higher. Hilo. We were free and that would be opposite. Don't get really the strength of the Hilo right now. Biggest strength seems to be for me right now drawing a fifth card. Here, to perform independent sensor. Yeah, okay. Yeah, but does it require a card for that? Independent sensor checks and attacks on its own. Using the sensor attack values printed on the Hilo card. Yeah, but it needs here something. It needs a torpedo for the fire value. But there are some optional rules, I need to check them out. There are some optional rules, I think, either in the manual and also in this here. To make the game... Yeah, for example, towered sonar arrays, enhanced countermeasures... Action values might be modified. Secure communications, Oscar 2 satellite targeting. Yeah, this might be even cooler with those rules. As this game is very old, yeah, and this here was developed in 2014. On the basis of 20 years experience with this game, I guess some of those players that developed good rules. For example, reaction counter fire is a nice one. Allows you to counter fire, but with -1 to total fire strength. But if you hold a good torpedo hand, you can counter fire. Yeah, counter fire is a typical thing. Somebody would fire on your torpedo, you might, in order to, and it is a dangerous torpedo, you might go for the snapshot. The counter torpedo, in order to survive, in order to draw the tracking, the original fire, in order to put him into defensive. Otherwise he might sit there and steer that torpedo conveniently into you while you are running like a madman. Good, let's see helos. Is there anything... Helos need to play their own cards, is that correct? Sensor detection, helicopters. Yeah, when PS card used to search. No active sonar bonus gained, why? I mean, the Hilo active sonar is probably not so strong as those surface ships, but it's closer probably to the submarine. Oh, AS bonus is applied. I don't know, this is a bit... Yeah, something I guess that is written for advanced players. What I want to see, what can we do when, during a turn? So I'm missing something that is very important. A lot of stuff you can do here. Card plays. Can we lock on? No. Yeah, exactly. Parry, try to detect. And everybody else. Let's cut perhaps the torpedo 4. And the close open range. I need new cards. 2. 5. Yeah, I could now say I want to detect the November, but. Yeah, probably I would really want to do that because the November is about to fire on us. I don't, yeah, but I would know perhaps because she is closing in aggressively and they're starting to bunker their hands. Yeah, let's say we are going for that and we succeeded. We gain one on the November. Yeah, and contact data is shared. I think I forgot that. I already didn't do that. Contact data between surface ships is always shared. So if one ship gains a plus or a helo, yes, a helo is, doesn't matter. But if one ship gets a plus, the other ship gets a plus as well. I think I did that wrong. Should be already having way higher contact levels. Because I did once this. Okay, whatever, that's fine. We could now use the helo for a torpedo attack. That would be 4, 6, plus additional value. We could fire on a November. And defense 8. November has quite a high defense. Yeah, that is the wrong torpedo. Yeah, okay, no, forget. We need more contact level. Wait, COR. COR was what again? Again, standing for check Aaron after use. See you. Those open range, yeah, okay. This means after the mothership moves or the surface group moves, we need to check if the helo can maintain or needs to go back for refueling or whatever. But this helo card is not really important for us. Here for the Soviet side, we might play a close. On the... We don't need to go closer with the November. I'm waiting for a good card to amp up this attack. Something like... Something... Yeah, I wouldn't play a active sonar. So, but we don't need... No, this card, I have no actions left. Okay, yeah, let's... Otherwise, I wanted to go in with the Victor 3. But I want also to get rid of the helo card. And draw it away. So we get rid of the helo card and play close open range with the Victor 3. That is... Ray. Oh, to make it harder for them. So they have a target-rich environment. They can't fight only don't need to fight only one ship. That is a big advantage if you stay together. They can't focus on one. Yeah, let's see how this now turns out. Did I increase my level? Is it only one? I think I've been increased. Okay. Yeah, torpedo attack. Yeah, the healer will perform the torpedo attack. It gets plus 2 to attack. Now the healer is here to pull it off. This will be... Yeah, now it doesn't look good for one. Question is, who do we want to nuke? I would say the Victor 3. Yeah. We will attack the Victor 3. A hilo that makes 2, 4, 7, 8, 9. Forget 16. 16. That is absolutely gonna. Jimmy, you don't need to bring anything here. 16 damage by the hilo. And now we draw what happens to the Victor 3. Attack 2 is damaged. The submarine is sunk. Yeah, the sensor value was also damaged once, but that is not important anymore. And now we need to perform if the helo can stay aloft. No. Discarded. This here, red X, means the helo is called back because of bad weather. If you call this card with your sensor or whatever, the sensor will malfunction. If you try to fire and you get this, your weapons will malfunction. Malfunction looks like this. And if you try to repair it, you might fail it. It's worse. Or it is down. If it is down, it can't be repaired anymore. And you're sitting ducks. At least you could end up with a ship that is out of mission killed. I think a system that is completely broken can't be repaired anymore, but perhaps it can. Yeah, Hilo is gone. Killed the Victor 3. Was rather sudden. He draws some good torpedo attacks there, with a good contact. November class is now about to revenge. Ah, damn it, what is this? The bad. Attack. Four. What is the sense of the attack value? Two. That is six. They have currently a firm lock on you. Hey, wait. Let's play first contact reduction. A contact level reduction. On the off camp. The Virginia is also formidable, like a helo. Plus 2 to the attack value. So if they draw good torpedo cards, it's over for me. I need more, that is not enough. So I'll play a contact reduction card on the entire surface group, basically. Success. And managed. This might buy us some time. Problem is, managing the hand will now become a problem. I can't get rid of those cards. Those Jimmys will now go all in. Yeah. No, wait, but the Oscar will also. No. Would you active ping? I don't think so. If you close range, the torpedo close range as well. You could say one ship you can risk, but right now I wouldn't do anything if I would be the surface group. You could even say on a long play, on a real professional tournament play, you would disengage the November and wait for the next helo or whatever. I don't know. Yeah, I might discard two cards. Now I need to perhaps tank, or I need to bring in torpedoes. Or helos. I mean, I know that the enemy doesn't have, but if I active ping, they can fire a torpedo on me. Need to get ready for this attack. Drawing no good cards. I would like to have, yeah, I don't know even what I want to have. A third torpedo. Yeah, but that's not a world where you can wish for. The November has only one chance to handle that. Four, six. I draw a good card. They might do it. I mean, if I wouldn't see the, if I wouldn't be aware of the enemy deck, I would fire, because if those guys discarding and not doing anything, I would assume they're getting ready for launch. Good, we have attack value, fire value of 4, plus 2 is 6. I'm firing on the Perry, although the Virginia would be a bigger target. And perhaps I would receive a hero of the Soviet Union. It's a nuclear guided cruiser. Or nuclear guided missile cruiser. CGN. Blow that thing up, that is, yeah, let's go for the tonnage. That thing has 11,000, that thing has 4,000. But here we need to defeat, yeah, 8. Jimmy, go in. Fire on the Virginia. But, yeah. Guess I wouldn't wait longer, because if I wouldn't be aware, I might say, next turn is over for me. You could also open range, but what am I supposed to do? I mean, you could open range, tank torpedoes, come back in. Yeah, you can replay cat and mouse in this game. You can play cat and mouse all day. That's what I mean. If you're really going into this game, then you could get out of range. They might come at you, but I mean, they currently have the advantage. Yeah? Over time, they will develop a solid contact on you. So that is another reason why I would go in with the November and try at least to hit. Come on, give me a strong card. Okay. Let's see if the Virginia... Virginia. Yeah, Virginia. Can't do that. They have an evasive action of -1. Launching noisemakers, but I have the strength of 2, 4, 6, 13, and that noisemaker is doing nothing. I wonder those evasive actions. I need to read about that. If that is really working like this, perhaps an evasive action can cancel an entire card. Here it reads -1 fire value. If you have a strong torpedo attack like this, you could have 10 evasive cards. You couldn't evade it. But perhaps that is also, again, simulating the reality. If somebody has a solid lock on you, a solid contact solution, and fires torpedoes at you, those countermeasures will do nothing. Those countermeasures are not there, like in those movies where the torpedoes go away and come never back. Those countermeasures are there. If you launch in countermeasures, a lot of stuff already went wrong. And most modern torpedoes you can't defeat that easily. Yeah, looks good, Virginia. Now we will check what the Virginia receives for damage. Sensor 2. And one attack value. And yeah, this is flipped. Defense is permanently reduced by the torpedo impact. Yeah, and I, as a parry or a US player, would say this guy now launched this entire torpedo and probably all cards he has there. He also didn't equip his torpedoes with a passive sonar card, which means he A, is really planning for that, or B, he has not a single one in play. I will now go for two active sonars, active sonar pings, which will increase the 4. Yeah, I think that is correct, to 4. Yeah, I need to check that, but every ship that increases it for the entire group. So if you play 2, you end up with 4 because they're sharing links. We double check the rules on that, but that's how it works. And now this guy is in our sights. I wonder, yeah, if he would play a passive card, I wonder if he can do it twice. But he doesn't get a passive card, unluckily. F1 torpedo, that is fire 1, that is a joke, yeah. Fire 3, I can't defeat the defense. I mean, those guys have a solid fix on me. I will go immediately active sonar and ping back. Can't get worse. Yeah, I can't discard cards. With fire 1 torpedo, I need other cards. Put this engage to 3. But that's it. So we gain 1 on the surface group. We're also not allowed to draw 5 cards anymore. I noticed. So I will discard this card and another one. Yeah, the Virginia is playing damage control. DC is not countered. No, DC can't be countered. You can only counter actions that are performed on the other ship. On you. And we are repairing sensors. Now wait, damage control needs to be rolled. It is not... only malfunctions need to be rolled. better double check. No, there is no check. Only for malfunction repairs. Except you have a technician. Good, I spent one action for damage control. I might spend one action to discard open close range because that is not important anymore. And I might play battle stations in order to discard two cards. That is rather not a good use for battle stations, but I have full contact level. I need torpedoes as many as I can have. Jimmy fired a torpedo. Perhaps you draw a card with 8 or 9, who knows. This is the last chance, I guess. Next turn it's over. They draw cards and there are minimum 2 torpedoes and it's over. Oh, let's try it out. 6. Yeah, that's not too shabby. Let's calculate. 6. 2. That is 8. Yeah, you can defeat the Virginia. Totally, you do it. If we could also fire on the parry. Wait, if he fire on a parry, we might kill it. Nah, come on, go for the guided missile cruiser there. That is hero of the Soviet Union. Hero of the Soviet Union. Wait, can they? Nah, they can't counter. They have no evasive action. I say discard everything for the attack. You see, if you prepare for attack, you might run into a desperate November attack. Virginia killed by November. Let's see what is the damage. Attack 2. Yeah, it's over. The Virginia is sinking. This reactor, this her reactor. The November fired a desperate torpedo and indeed hit. So Perry is also not only allowed to draw 2 cards of 4. Tony, it's over. Yeah, okay, do we need to calculate that? I mean, yeah, the counter exactly as we assumed. The counter is incoming. That is 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, okay. 7. That is not enough. Wait. 4, 5, 6, 7, 0. Yeah, torpedo attack fails. Without a single evasive action by the November. This is becoming again here quite interesting. Can the Soviets turn it around? That is here like a football match. Can the Soviets turn it around? And the US was moving in already, champagne, everything. Was thinking that will be an easy finish. Suddenly the missile cruiser nuked, literally nuked. And that was probably the worst missile miss, the worst torpedo miss in history. But we draw only crap. I need to discard. Yeah. I need cards. House of cards. I can't discard my entire hand. The problem of the November class right now. If I would draw battle stations, I could get rid of those cards. Yeah, but it's not better looking for them. I mean, they could try to reduce my opponent's contact level, which is succeeded. November is used to 2. November can also reduce the enemy opponent, the opponent's. That's it. Ah, wait, I countered that. I countered that. I countered that. With this card. I need to watch out for those counters. That is also super important because I need to get rid of cards. That is really important. Okay, I get countered the contact reduction. And drawing a fourth card. Now I'm going for my own contact reduction. I fail. Yeah, the parry is getting out of range. It's opening range. Because it also has a ton of passive zones and whatever. So contact level is reduced for the November to 3. November loses also 1. But this is currently worse for the November. We have no weapon lock. I'm discarding a noisemaker. Those active zoners. What am I supposed to do with all those active zoners? But we're going in for the passive. Passive zoner sensor value is 3. Plus. Passive sensor, sensors fail. We have a malfunction. Sensors are reduced 1. This X is indicating a malfunction. The parry. The US on almost victorious. Now we're having an issue here. Drawing not good cards. Also discarding if Sona. Want to go active? Here we are attempting passive detection. Sensor value is 1, yeah, that is pretty bad. We need to defeat 6. One need to draw 4 more. And he does it. November class. Luckiest submarine in the Soviet fleet. Is detecting contact level is rising up to 3. We are ready to fire. But I want another torpedo. Yeah. Perry is going also in for passive detection. That's a minus 1. Wait, how is repair? How are repairs working? All contacts are reduced by 1. If there would be another friendly ship, that wouldn't happen. But because there is no other friendly ship, the Perry is losing 1 contact because of the sensor malfunction on the November class. Repairs. A repair attempt is a sole attempt. And if you roll 4 or higher, or use a technician, if you fail the repair, ah, okay, you can also repair down systems. If any repair attempt draws an X, the entire system goes down. Okay. Yeah, so repair is risky. You draw an X while trying to repair. I need to get rid of cards, yeah, I can't wait now for repairs, I need torpedoes. I can only discard one card per turn, is that correct? Important to know, but yeah. And discard multiple cards, is it? That's a game changer. Yeah, okay. You can discard one or more cards when you don't take an action. A player or a ship? A player who takes no actions. Okay, yeah, I played that wrong. Might be changing the entire game. Yeah, I might need to re-record that. But it's called, the video is called Learning, not called Professional Play, so it's fine. But I think now I got the grasp of all rules, yeah. You can discard all cards as a single player, not as a single ship. But I need to get rid of that. Specify that. I will write a command and then it's fine. So who is currently here in action? The US. I'm doing nothing and discarding my entire hand. Yeah, let's keep perhaps one active sonar around for the worst times. Okay, this changes. And the November doesn't care and goes in for the weapon lock. The weapon lock on the parry. Both are locked, or he would be too lucky. Yeah? Impossible that he draws more than 8. Yeah, he fails. Okay. Luck of the November is out. Now the parry class is drawing 3 cards. Got a weapon lock and a helo. We are launching the helo. That's it. Another torpedo. Fire 3. Discard all cards. Get ready for the launch. Go for active sonar. Yeah, perhaps. There go, active sonar. And yeah, did you draw cards? I think so. And we can draw back 5. Wait, I used one card. So that is fine. 5. Because of the helo, we get an additional card. Three. Plus 1, yeah, and plus 1 I used. God of Records. God of Records. Everybody's waiting for the attack, but I should have used active sonar in order to get a good lock on that. This torpedo, but this is rather a crap torpedo. Requiring strong lock, but weak attack. Oh, I need to close in, and we might finish him off. I can't close in right now. He's firing passive sonar. This was his sensor malfunction. It's a good idea, but thing has a value of 5 only. Can handle that. That is, sensor value is 2 plus. This guy's getting ready. The November class of Doom. Jimmy, I mean, I don't know about his hand. I might also close in because of my torpedo. If I wouldn't know about what this guy is carrying, I might go close in. Right now, not because of the torpedo. Play the reduce opponent's contact level. Success. November class, yeah, what do you want to do with those torpedoes? Jimmy, I need to discard 2 cards, otherwise it will take too long. We never will get to 4 in time. Yeah, I can now play 2 actions because of the helo. Play 2 contact reductions. And contact reduction is not triggering a helo check, is that correct? Yeah, I don't perform an attack, need a sensor check. One success. Yeah, the November is now getting here outperformed by this Hilo surface team. Going in active sonar. November is trying getting out of range. But it's too late, I mean we can fire 2 torpedoes. We have a no lock with this one now. That is a 5. When fired by the helo, that is 5, 6, 7. So, fifth card. Yeah, it's over. Over November. Nidor's going in. But November, that was a nice fight. I mean, you sank a missile guided cruiser. A guided missile cruiser. Nuclear guided missile cruiser. Okay, let's calculate. That is. Yeah, he's a goner. You don't need to calculate. It's over. But yeah, it was a nice try by the November here. And yeah, I played. How do we want to do that? I mean, I want to do one correct play, but now it is too late. This discard rule is very important. Keep that in mind, that you can discard your entire hand if you play with your entire force if you do nothing. You can check how the next scenario will look like. Yeah, US and British sub versus three Soviet subs. Alpha, Charlie 2, Victor 3. Yeah, but next time. So, good hunting.